So I'd like to kick us off by passing the mic to Saundra Mitrovich with the National Congress of American Indians.
Thank you, Dan. I also want to thank the amazing charge team members that are present today on this panel, and all of the folks that aren't on this panel today that have been instrumental in drafting the redistricting report card work overall. So my name is Saundra Mitrovich, and I have the distinct pleasure of working alongside wonderful colleagues and partners at the National Congress of American Indians. NCAI is a policy advocacy organization in service to 574 federally recognized tribal nations, state-recognized tribal nations, and over 9 million American Indian Alaska Native people in the United States. I lead the overall civic engagement work on behalf of our member tribal nations, and that includes everything from census redistricting, the American Community Survey, and voting rights. NCAI has served in support of the Charge Hub Collaborative to expand reach into Indian country to support nonpartisan Native vote redistricting efforts. In this cycle, we focused on many things, but most specifically in supporting our tribal leaders in engaging both their state and local redistricting processes, provided ongoing support and resources to all the engaged activities that both local grassroots organizers were doing on the ground, additional advocacy, supporting and partnering with different attorneys at the local level, which I'll talk about a little bit later, and provided technical assistance on assessing the quality of the PL94171 redistricting summary file after the U.S. Census Bureau applied its final disclosure avoidance system, otherwise known as differential privacy measures, and supported staff to carry out those activities through our Policy Research Center. Through various webinars, as Dan mentioned, and virtual trainings, we found that with all our Native Counts Coalition Native leaders not only needed guidance and retrieval on how to retrieve and use the data, so we created reports, but also additional training in using the mapping tools within their communities. Thankfully, we leaned into several tribal leaders throughout various different states and really important organizations serving on local redistricting commissions and within other local advocacy hubs throughout the process, including our Charge Hub. So Native leadership in redistricting was really crucial in this cycle. And we saw after the decennial census how important that was in getting both people counted, but also in making sure that all areas, including those Western states with high populations of American Indian Alaska Native people, could be counted more accurately. So states like Alaska, California, and New Mexico shared some very important key components in their redistricting efforts, which aided in part to successful outcomes for tribal nations. One of those very specific areas was tribal leadership being both either centered or formally included, ensuring that state-based coalitions were inclusive of an American Indian Alaska Native voice from the very beginning in the redistricting process with some commissions, and then also either potentially throughout the formalized process, updating stakeholder input. So in states like Alaska, which received a grade of B in the report, as you read through, two Alaska Natives that are also mentioned in our charge report, Nicole Borromeo, Vice President and General Counsel for Alaska Federal Federation of Natives, and Melanie Bonke, President of the Karak Tribal Consortium, served on a 5-member redistricting board. Those two Alaska Native leaders were able to increase and strengthen both the outreach plan to not only the urban areas, but also targeted the rural villages in just about every part of the state. Their work secured a Senate district in East Anchorage, Alaska, that rather than splitting, unified that district. As a result, the adopted map provided Alaska Native communities like Muldoon an opportunity to have a voice in the electoral process. Although states like New Mexico didn't necessarily have tribal leaders on their Citizen Redistricting Commission, or otherwise known as the CRC, which is a criticism we heard throughout various different interviews and reports back, tribal leaders and organizers responded that over time, through meaningful and inclusive partnering on both webinars virtually and listening sessions, that they were included additionally throughout the process in organizing across the state. In this cycle, it was the first time there was a Native American coalition led by the Native American Voting Alliance, or also otherwise known as NAVA, that pushed for fair process and representative maps. Our ongoing testimony and map drawing was key in passing the final maps, which secured power for Native voters in Northwest New Mexico. According to one of the state redistricting reports, one tribal leader reflected on the process in New Mexico by saying, "The CRC provided tribal leaders the space to share long historical context to educate them on the context of communities of interest. Typically, that context is not included in the discussion. Furthermore, tribal leaders felt their voice was heard and they were able to educate the CRC leadership. So we heard many of those successes throughout our time and working and interviewing and hearing from different leadership, but we also heard about some additional challenges and successes. Every state witnessed those challenges and successes, as you'll read about in the report, from the last redistricting cycle to this one. In Washington State, tribal leaders felt there was an improvement in early outreach to tribal nations, which created a stronger feedback loop throughout the redistricting process and arguably led to the success in keeping tribal communities together within districts, which one tribal leader commented, the tribal consultation policy was key in providing a consistent and equitable standard for the redistricting commission to continuously work with the 29 federally recognized tribes in Washington State, which led to great collaborative efforts within Native communities and with tribal leadership. If tribal leadership and tribal nations witnessed a greater sense of connection to the redistricting cycle, some organizations would also argue that another victory included the increased onboarding of grassroots Native-led organizations working on the census and redistricting initiatives alongside other advocacy organizations in their respective areas. Organizations like Four Directions, Native Organizers Alliance, Western Native Voice, California Native Vote Project, Great Plains Tribal Chairman's Association, New Mexico Native Vote, and Phoenix Indian Center were just a handful throughout the country working together on messaging, virtual webinars, and workshops to ensure Native voices were participating throughout the entire redistricting process. These organizations, like many others, including NCAI, were part of the Native American Voting Rights Coalition, led by the Native American Rights Fund, which many tribal nations leaned on for support, including numerous lawsuits and challenges. Some of these cases you'll read about in the report, but many others were decided after interviews were completed. And so we ask you to continue to follow up. This report is just a start. It is the ongoing election protection work that organizations like NARF, Four Directions, and partners like the ACLU and Demos do to promote the integrity of the electoral process. So what are some next steps for us? On the pathway to the 2030 decennial, the Native network of tribal nations, organizations, American Indian Alaska Native citizens, and all of our advocacy partners, including all of those in our charge hub, will work collaboratively to ensure that the momentum gained throughout this cycle and all areas of civic engagement don't weaken. Our goal is to remind our communities about all areas of electoral politics year in and year out, and that American Indian Alaska Native voices are needed in so many areas where our tribal nations should be leading. With our collective voices in partnership with our allies and advocacy organizations throughout the nation, we can continue to strengthen our representation and ensure an equitable and fair redistricting process. And we look forward to working with everybody. Thank you.
Thanks, Saundra. We're going to pass it over to Marika.
I think it's actually Elena now.
Oh, I'm sorry. My bad.
That's okay. Thank you, Dan and Saundra and the rest of the